Well, good morning. I want to welcome you into worship this morning. We are starting a new message series this summer, kind of how we did last summer. When it's coming to summer weeks, I like to have a little bit of fun in church, and so we're going to be focusing on some movies over the next couple of weeks, and today we're talking from Luke's Gospel. We're talking about the story of when some friends opened a hole in the roof of a place where Jesus was in order to get their friend in front of Jesus so that he may heal them. They were stretcher bearers for him, and there is a movie where we're going to talk about today that is a perfect illustration of what a stretcher bearer is and looks like, and the power that a stretcher bearer, the difference that a stretcher bearer can make in someone's life. But before we get into that, I wanted to show off, these are some of my campers from Minecraft camp this week. There was a thing we were doing to talk about how we all work together as the body of Christ and how we all have a purpose in the body of Christ. And so I kind of made them into accidental stretcher bearers. They were given the task of working first in a group of four to take a little wooden person from the one side of the room to the next. And then I made them work in groups of eight to get one person from one end of the room to the next. And then I made the entire camp, all of my kids, come around one small little paper plate with a bunch of strings tied to it, and they had to maneuver a little wooden person from one end of the room to the other. I was expecting chaos because that seems like a really hard task, because I had one camper that was 6'4" and I had one camper that was very much not, and I was just kind of expecting things to go awry. But to my surprise and to the glory of God, we did not drop a single person that entire time. This camp understood what it was like to be a stretcher bearer, understood what it was like to work together with one another, because they'd been doing it all week through some other stuff at camp, and this was one of the very last full days of camp. But I just think it's important for us to look at this image and just to remember what we're talking about today. We're talking about bearing one another in a season when we just feel like we are stuck. We're talking about what it means to be supportive and what it means to seek out support when we're the one that feels paralyzed. That happens in this movie called The Emperor's New Groove, but it also happens in our lives. So I just want us to keep in mind the people that have supported us when we have felt stuck, and the people that maybe feel stuck around us, and what are some of those creative ideas that we can have as the body of Christ to support others. So let's keep that on the front part of our brain as we go through worship this morning.
Before a moment, it's all I've ever where my feet will stand on holy ground. I am bound for glory. I am free because I'm bound. I am bound for heaven's gate, where my feet will stand on holy ground. I am bound for glory. Where my feet will stand on holy ground. I am bound for glory.
Song. Let's stand and sing this song together. This is the cat's meow. That's what she said.
You know, Josh fit the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Oh, Josh fit the battle of Jericho, and the walls come tumbling down. Other Josh fit the battle of Jericho, oh, Jericho, oh, oh, oh. Josh fit the battle of Jericho, and the walls come tumbling down. You may talk about your man called Gideon, you may talk about your man of Saul, but there's nobody like a Joshua who fought the battle of Jericho. You may talk about your man called Gideon, you may talk about your man of song, but there's nobody like a Joshua who fought the battle of Jericho. I said that Josh fit the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Oh, Josh fit the battle of Jericho, and the walls come tumbling down. We know Josh fit the battle of Jericho, oh-oh, Jericho, oh-oh-oh. Josh fit the battle of Jericho, and the walls come tumbling down. A sheep, a bop, a beedle-dee-bee, a zaba beep bop beep bop beedle dee ba da ba dee a bop a beedle dee a zee da bee dee bee na 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 da zoot zoot da da a zee da bee dee yeah a zoot bop bee da I'll be it up, be it be not, not, not. Josh fit the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Oh, Josh fit the battle of Jericho, and the walls go tumbling down. We sing Josh fit the battle of Jericho, wow, oh, wow, oh. Jericho, wow, oh, wow, oh, wow. Oh, oh. Josh fit the battle of Jericho, and the walls go tumbling down. And the walls go tumbling down. And the walls go tumbling down. And the walls come a-tumbling down.
You may have a seat.
Let's pray together. The words are on the screen. Creative and creating God, as we look at the world around us, we marvel at your imaginative work. You have come up with things that we cannot even fathom.
Yet as a sign that we are made in your image, you have made us into creative people. As we look for your fingerprints in movies, inspire our own creativity as we look for ways to bear your image in the world. Help us to thank those who have been
I got an extra line.
I was listening to this song on the radio, and I just was thinking about who leads my life, and if it's just me thinking that I'm in charge of every decision I make, and do I fully rely on God to direct my steps? There's many days I think that I have it figured out on my own, but then there's days I need to remember Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. It encourages me to trust in the Lord with all my heart and lean on not my own understanding, but in your ways submit to him. He will make your path straight. So today, I just want to remember to take God's lead and remember to listen to him by studying his word and taking time in the silence to just hear what he has to say to me. Sometimes the sun feels like it keeps me in the dark. Sometimes I find myself on journeys far too hard. I thought you turned your back on every hurt until I realized you're going first. You lead me through deserts no man has walked, through waters none dared cross. When I'm afraid of where I'll be, you lead me through flames that won't burn me down, showing me the way to the only way out. When it's all unknown, as far as I can see, you lead me. I close my eyes and hold on tightly to your hand. Don't know if I'm walking on water or sinking sand. Caught up in the storm of what I feel, I thought you were the sword, but you're the shield. You lead me through deserts no man has walked, through waters none dared cross. When I'm afraid of where I'll be, you'll lead me through flames that won't burn me down, showing me the way to the only way out. When it's all unknown, as far as I can see, you lead me. All I know, as
far as I can see, you lead me. You lead me. You lead me.
Living and loving and creative God, we give you thanks for this day. We give you thanks for drawing us together here in this place and virtually so we may be your people in worship. So that we can return thanks for the ways that you are moving and working in our lives in ways that we notice and in ways that you are yet to reveal. We give you thanks this day for your mercies, which your word called new every morning. We give you thanks for your grace and everything that that word means to us. God, we give you thanks for the way that you carry us in those hard moments of life and how you assemble people around us to help carry too. And we thank you for the ways that you use us to carry the burdens of others. One of those ways being through prayer. Today, O God, in the midst of our sharing, you have heard our hearts. You've heard our concern for cancer diagnoses, for ongoing treatments, for eye problems. For pastors and churches parting ways for the season. And for churches that have reached the end of their lives. God, bind us together. Bind up the wounds of those who hurt today. Bind up the hearts of those that mourn. And keep these things that we have listed and these things that we've named in our hearts. Keep them close to you. And move and work mightily in their midst. God, you've heard our celebrations for birthdays and anniversaries, for safe travel and good times with friends and family. And God, as your word calls us, we rejoice with those who rejoice, who know your love, who know your care this day. Increase our celebration. And make us ever mindful of the way that you are with us in the midst of good and bad, of plenty and lean, and everything in between. You are a God who is with us. And for this, let us continue to give thanks. As we bring once again our hearts before your throne, we do it with a unified voice, praying in the way that you taught your disciples to pray, saying this: Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. At this time, I want to invite our children forward for a time that's mostly just for them.
die, buddy.
Oof. How's it going? Good. Good deal. So how's summer going so far? Good. We're doing all right? Yeah? Enjoying a little bit of a break? Yeah? Big plans for the rest of summer? Yes? Yeah? All right. So this morning, I want to ask if you have ever had a bad day. You ever had a bad day? Yeah, had a storm at your house that woke you up and scared you. That's not a good day. What's a bad day look like? Yeah, when you don't feel good for some reason. Maybe your stomach hurts, maybe your head hurts. Yeah, that's not a good day. What else does a bad day look like? Ooh, you do bad on a test and like maybe even you fail it. Yeah, that's not a good day either, right? Thank God for summer so we can get rid of those kind of bad days, right? At least for a little bit. Yeah. Yeah, that's a bad day. Yeah. Maybe mom and dad are in a fender bender and like they, you know, bump something on their car. Yeah, that's not a very good day either. Yeah. We know what bad days are like, right? Oh no, I hate when that happens. Yeah. So, do bad days last forever? Yes? No? It kind of feels like they do, don't they? Yeah, bad days don't actually last forever. They just kind of feel that way sometimes. What is it that make bad days better? Taking a nap makes a bad day better. I am with you. You are my people. Eating snacks? Yeah? Eating snacks makes a bad day better? Yeah? What else? Does talking to someone make a bad day better? Certain bad days? Yeah? Does a hug from someone that you love make a bad day better? Yeah. Yeah, those are all kind of things that make bad days better. The thing that I'm noticing in most of those things is that they involve more people. People kind of help bad days feel better, right? And that is what is called a stretcher bearer. In the scripture we're going to read in just a little bit, there are people called stretcher bearers that come and carry their friend who cannot walk to Jesus. He's having not just a bad day, he's kind of having a bad life because he was born paralyzed, and that's not fun, right? And Jesus is willing to heal them because his friends did such a great job of making sure that he got to Jesus. Hey, buddy. Yeah. Yeah. So when we have a bad day, we can look for other people. And when someone else around us is having a bad day, what do you think we can do? Can we make it better? Yeah. Yeah, God calls all of us to be stretcher bearers, to help out when we can, and to make someone's bad day a little bit better. Yeah, that can either be by giving them a hug or just saying, hey, I see that you're having a bad day. Are you okay? And then maybe if you just say, yeah, I'm fine, but at least someone noticed. Someone noticing makes a bad day better, for at least for me. But I always want us to think about that as we go through our life, and I want us to think about that as we go through not even just the rest of our summer, but just the rest of our days. Help us to just let God help us to remember that that we can help out people that are around us. And so let's pray. I'm going to say a phrase and have you repeat it after me. Dear God, we thank you for today. We thank you that you're with us, even when we have bad days. When we see people around us having a bad day, inspire us to act, to make things better, as we express your love. In your name we pray. Amen. All right. Whether you're having a bad day or not, you can go grab a treat from the basket. That always makes our day better. And just then you can head back to your adults. Our scripture this morning comes to us from the Gospel of Luke in chapter 5. We'll be reading verses 17 through 26. One day, while Jesus was teaching, Pharisees and the teachers of the law were sitting nearby. They had come from every village of Galilee and Judea and even from Jerusalem, and the power of the Lord was with Jesus to heal. Just then some men came, carrying a paralyzed man on a bed. They were trying to bring him in and lay him before Jesus. But finding no way to bring him in because of the crowd, they went up to the roof and they let him down with his bed through the tiles in the middle of the crowd. They laid him in front of Jesus. When Jesus saw their faith, he said, "Friends, your sins are forgiven you." Then the scribes and the Pharisees began to question, "Who is this who is speaking blasphemies? Who can forgive sins but God alone?" When Jesus perceived their questionings, he answered them, "Why do you raise such questions in your heart? Which is easier to say, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or to say, 'Stand up and walk'? But so that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins," he said to the one who is paralyzed, "I say to you, stand up and take your bed and go on your way home." Immediately the paralyzed man stood up before them, took what he had been lying on, and went to his home, glorifying God. Amazement seized all of them, and they glorified God and were filled with awe, and they said, "We have seen some strange things today." Would you pray with me? Holy and gracious God, may the words of my mouth and the meditation of all of our hearts be holy and acceptable to you. For you, O God, are our rock, and you are our Redeemer. And we give you thanks for who you are as we say together, Amen. So to quote another movie that we're not going to be talking about this time around in this movie sermon series, the movie called August Rush, the main character says this at the very end of the movie: "Music is all around us. All we have to do is listen." And there are few quotes that better sum up how I feel about the gospel and how I feel about gospel parallels. The gospel of Jesus Christ is all around us. All we need to do is listen and look. The gospel is all around us. And I want to acknowledge and name that original authors and maybe even original creators may not have intended to proclaim the gospel, but so many movies and so many stories perfectly capture the gospel. And so over the next couple of weeks, we're going to be looking at movies that inadvertently but effectively proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ and help us to live in its light. And I happen to find the gospel themes in a lot of movies, and so I'm really, really happy to start today with my second favorite movie of all time, called The Emperor's New Groove from Disney. Together, we're going to talk about how the roles and relationships in that movie connect to the gospel of Luke. So The Emperor's New Groove, it was released in 2000, and it centers around the emperor whose name is Cusco. And in relation to Luke's gospel, Cusco is a one-man crowd because there is no room for anyone else in his life. There is no room for anyone to get close to him. He is self-centered and insufferable. He is out of touch with reality and truly believes that the world revolves around him. The movie starts with this big, flashy opening number, this elaborate dance, and during the course of this dance, Cusco bumps into someone and then has him banished from the castle because he has thrown off the emperor's groove. Let's take a look at what that looks like. So after that opening number, we see even more of Cuzco's self-centered behavior. Cuzco, at the start of the movie, has an assistant named Yzma, and very shortly after we meet her, Cuzco fires her. Fires Yzma and her assistant named Kronk. And then Cuzco meets with a villager named Pacha, who he has summoned to the emperor's castle only to tell him that he's about to level the village where Pacha and his family live so that he can build a summer home called Cuzcotopia. But after Yzma and Kronk turn him into a llama, which is not their initial plan, Cuzco's groove is entirely thrown off. The llama emperor ends up on Pacha's cart and tries to find his way home, and he nearly dies, but Pacha rescues him. And then Cuzco accepts Pacha's terms for help, and they both make their way back to Cuzco's home. And these two strange compatriots are initially at odds, but they learn how to cooperate. They get on each other's good side. They reconcile their differences. And they realize who the true villains are and they team up to stop Yzma and Kronk from taking over the government. Our scripture for this morning from Luke's gospel is an entirely different story with the same effect. Jesus' groove is thrown off. Jesus in the Gospels is teaching in Capernaum in someone's home, and the crowd that has gathered is so large that there is no room for anybody else to enter in the house. There is barely room to move. There isn't even standing room only available at this point. And the crowd is either unable or unwilling to move out of the way because there is a group of people trying to bring their friend to Jesus. But undeterred by the lack of space, and undeterred by the size of the crowd, the friends of this paralyzed man get creative. They throw off the groove as they climb to the top of the house, as they peel back a piece of the roof, and there they lower their friend into Jesus' midst. And then Luke says this, and these are some of my favorite words in the entire gospel. Luke says this: Jesus saw their faith and healed the paralyzed man. Jesus saw their faith. Because these friends would stop at nothing to get their friend to Jesus, Jesus healed. Not because of the paralyzed man, but because of his friends. Because his friends had this bedrock, non-negotiable, soul-defining faith. Jesus healed. This is the power of a stretcher bearer. They were stretcher bearers. And Jesus says to the friends, and Jesus says to the man, stand up and take your mat and go home. And that's exactly what they did. Everyone in the house was amazed. Everyone in the house praised God. Everyone in the house went forth and says, man, that was crazy. Jesus did something that we've never seen before. These friends were his stretcher bearers. And because of them, this man's life, the life of the paralyzed man, his life was never the same. This is what we would call in a movie a supporting role, and maybe even the best supporting role. In the world of film and theater, an actor that is in a role that is not the lead actor is what's called a supporting role. And sometimes movies don't have the right lead actor, but if they have the right, supporting actors, it can still be an okay movie. And in recognition of the important nature of this supporting work, both theater and film give out awards to best supporting actors and best supporting actresses. And I don't know if you've noticed this or not, but at award shows, sometimes the very first award given is to that of a best supporting actor, because the industry understands how important that work is. They give them the honor of having the first award. In all gospel stories, Jesus is the leading actor, and he is the best leading actor, right? In all gospel stories, Jesus is the leading actor, but without supporting characters, today being the friends of the paralyzed man, healing would not have happened. This is the importance of a stretcher bearer. This is the importance of the role that these friends played in the life of the paralyzed man. And if we need any more examples of what a stretcher bearer looks like, we need to only look as far as the Emperor's New Groove. Yzma needed the support of Kronk in order to survive and basically function as a human. Pacha, the villager, needed his family to remind him that some things are worth fighting for. After he sees the human Cusco and gets this news about the summer home and his village being destroyed, he goes back to his family, and on the journey he is so defeated and so dejected and just so resigned to what seems to be inevitable. But then he sees his family. He sees his wife who is pregnant and their two kids, and he is reinvigorated. He knows that something must be done. What exactly that is not completely clear. But then he finds the llamified emperor on his cart, speaking of whom Cusco needed Pacha. Cusco may have well literally died a few times in the movie without Pacha's interaction. But even more than that, Pacha's kindness and determination inspire Cusco to undergo the personal changes that make this movie a classic. There's a pivotal moment at the end of the movie where Cusco is on the verge of receiving the human potion that would turn him back into a human, and Pacha is on the verge of falling off the cliff of the palace. And now the old Cusco at the beginning of the movie, the guy that threw the guy out the window, he would have let Pacha fall, because who cares? Cusco is the center of the universe. But here, near the end of the film, because he had a stretcher bearer, because he has had someone in his life to be a supporter, to show him compassion and care, Cusco rescues Pacha. They recover the potion, they turn Cusco the emperor back into a human, but they don't turn him into the same person. He is not the same because of everything that he has been through. And friends in Christ, this is the power of a stretcher bearer. This is the importance of a supporting role. Pacha supported Cusco when his life was torn apart by those who sought to do him harm. The friends of the paralyzed man supported him as they sought healing from Jesus. And he is not the same either. And I know that I would not be where I am, and I know that I would not be who I am if I hadn't had stretcher bearers in my life. Everyone needs a stretcher bearer like these. Everyone needs a friend or friends who will carry you when you are at your weakest. Everyone needs someone who will carry you, not only to pray for you, but also do whatever it takes to get back on your feet. And not only does everyone need that, we can all be that, right? Not only does everyone need that, we can all be that. The reality of our life and the reality of our faith is that we will go through times when life is hard, when we can feel quite frankly paralyzed. The reality of our lives is that sometimes we will go through times in our faith when we feel distant from God and just simply stuck there. We can be paralyzed by our sin. We can be incapacitated by our circumstances. We can even be numbed to the suffering of the world. Enter the stretcher bearers, the creative thinkers, the devoted disciples of Jesus Christ. We can be stretcher bearers. We can make the presence of Jesus real and tangible and attainable to the world around us that is looking for someone to help. Friends in Christ, let us strive to be a Pacha. Let us strive to be a Kronk. Let us strive to be a stretcher bearer. Would you pray with me? Holy God, we give you thanks for the way that you move and work in our lives. And we give you thanks for people that come alongside of us to make things a little bit easier, to bear our burdens, to ease our pain, to reinvigorate us. We thank those people in our lives, and we are inspired to be those people for others. Open our eyes to opportunities that are around us. Open our hearts and increase our capacity and creativity to support others so that all may glorify your name in which we pray. Amen. At this time, I'm going to invite our Zebarth family forward to give a special music offering called Find Us Faithful.
Faithful. May the
Thank you so much, Seabirth, and then happy anniversary to you. Like Yzma and Kronk and Pacha and Kuzco and the paralytic and his friends, we need each other to support each other and even in times bear one another. Let us see the world as our creative God sees it and be inspired to stop at nothing to bring our friends to Jesus' love. Let's stand as we sing our closing song today, Lean On Me.
Ooh, yeah. Ooh, 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 yeah. Ooh, ooh, ooh,
ooh. 2, 3, 4. True MC. Everybody knows this True MC. True MC, no slack on the track. Here to tell the people that love's what we lack. In this family, we got a love like Christ. So precise in your life, so take this advice. Brother to brother, we need to learn to love each other. So lean on me when you're in trouble. I cast my cares on Christ, cause he cares for me. So when you need a shoulder to cry on,
you just lean.
Props to my man, Rocky.
1, 2, 3. Lean on me when you're not strong. I'll be your friend, I'll help you carry on. For it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. Sometimes in our lives we all have pain, we all have sorrows, but if we are wise, when you're not strong, then I'll be your friend, and I'll help you carry on. For it won't be long,
and
I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. So please, let's follow your pride. If I have things that you need to borrow, when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend, I'll help you carry on. For it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. So you can just call on me,
brother,
when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. And I just might have some problems that you don't understand. Yeah,
you understand.
We all need somebody to lean on me.
Yeah.
When you're not strong, and I'll be your friend, I'll help you carry on. 4, 5, it won't be long.
It won't be long.
And I'm gonna need somebody to. Make it funky, make it funky. Make it funky, make it funky. Make it funky, make it funky. Yeah.
So I'm housing this church like a brother with an attitude. I'm coming straight, so you best give me an attitude. Me and all my boys from the word you go. And me and them for them,
cause the Lord said so.
So many of us just don't go. From the boy named Drew, don't talk about how he stumbles and falls. Just beat it, lean on
you. You can just call me, just call me, just call me.
Having a bad day, just call me.
Just call me, just call me, just call me.
Yeah.
Don't you know that I'll be there?
I'll be there.
Can't leave.
Have a great week, everyone. Be there for each other, and happy Father's Day.